Hello everyone, again welcome to the new lecture of complex analysis. So if you follow my channel or if you follow my lecture series, whatever we have given in complex analysis, the last lecture whatever we have uploaded, that was basically the idea of mapping or transformation, and there we have given that what is bilinear map and how you can find a bilinear map. If 3 points are given, that is 3 point maps to 3 points, then how can you find the bilinear map? So today's class will give you some new concept which will make our job a bit easier. Okay, so let's start. So today's the first idea will be cross ratio. So what is the definition or what is the meaning of cross ratio is that if there are four complex number z1, z2, z3, z4, then cross ratio, which sometimes denoted by C dot R, of z1, z2, z3, z4, this is denoted like this. You see this one is very important. Look into the order. So z1 minus z2, z1 minus z2, then Z3 minus Z4, Z3 minus Z4, then in the denominator it will be Z1, it will be Z3, the second term will be changed, that is Z1 minus Z4 minus Z2. So what is the meaning of cross ratio? That this quantity is called cross ratio of four complex number. Okay, so how you can write the same thing? First you have to write it in proper order, then only you can find the exact cross ratio. Okay, so z1 minus z2, z3 minus z4, so first minus second, third minus fourth, so you go serially in the numerator. In the denominator, the subtracted part will be altered, so in place of the first subtraction, this will come and this will go there. So this is the cross ratio. Okay, now what is the utility of cross ratio? What is the utility of cross ratio? If Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 maps to W1, W2, W3, W4 by a bilinear map, then cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 will be equals to cross ratio of W1, W2, W3, W4. So if there is a bilinear map, which we have discussed in the previous lecture, which maps Z1 to W1, Z2 to W2, Z3 to W3 and Z4 to W4, what is bilinear map? So for your understanding, this is something like AZ plus B, CZ plus D, provided AD minus BC not equals to 0. So if there is a bilinear map which maps this one, then the cross ratio of this domain is equals to the cross ratio of the range where it is going. Okay, so now you can think, what is the utility of cross ratio for solving a problem? So let us give one problem. So say one problem, say find the bilinear map which maps, find the bilinear map which maps 1, 0 minus 1, which maps 1, 0 minus 1 I minus 1 to I 0 minus I. So what is given? Try to understand this one. What you have to find? You have to find a bilinear map. What is given? 1 maps to I, then second I maps to 0, minus I maps to minus 1 maps to minus I. This is given to us. What we have to find? We have to find a map like this, that is AZ plus B divided by CZ plus D. So let Z tends to W or Z maps to W. So this is our assumption. So that means what we have done, these three are given and we assume that Z maps to W. That means now we have got four elements here, we have got four elements here. So what we have got? We have got 1i minus 1 z. This maps to I 0 minus I w. Now we have got this. Now it is a bilinear map. So the cross ratio of this one will be same as the cross ratio of this one. So what we get? So we get cross ratio of 1i minus 1 z equals to cross ratio of I 0 minus I w. So that means, this means now look into the writing style. So first one minus second one, 1 minus I minus 1 minus z divided by 1 minus z and minus 1 minus I equals to I minus 0 minus I minus W divided by I minus W minus I minus 0. So this is the writing style which you need to follow. Now the left hand side will be same, the right hand side will be, say here minus I, here I. So if it eliminate, there will be minus 1. So this minus 1 I can take in the numerator. So the numerator will be I plus W and denominator will be I minus W. So now, and this side it was the same thing, 1 minus I minus 1 minus Z and 1 minus Z minus 1 minus I. Now if you cross multiply, it should be I minus W. So if I cross multiply, it should be I minus W. Then the multiplication of this one. So this is minus 1 minus Z plus I plus IZ. Okay, equals to I plus W. So cross multiplication of this one. This is, if I multiply 1, so minus 1 minus I plus Z plus IZ. So carefully see what we have done. We have not multiplied this W quantity. We have multiplied this Z quantity and we have got this. Okay. Now this one I can write I times this one minus 1 minus Z plus IZ minus W times minus 1 minus Z plus IZ equals to I times minus 1 minus I plus IZ plus W times minus 1 minus I plus IZ. So one, you should take, always you take some precaution that you should not multiply all, then the pattern will vanish. You keep it in this form. Now what is the facility of this one? I, this I, if I take in this side, so I can take I common. So whatever will be there, minus 1 minus z plus IZ. Now this I, if I came in the left hand side, it should be minus. So it should be plus 1 plus I minus z minus IZ. Okay, equals to W times, what will be there? This one is already there, minus 1 minus I plus z plus IZ. Now this W, if it go in the right hand side, it should be plus. So minus 1 minus Z plus I plus IZ. Now see, the calculation is becoming very simple. Now few terms will get got eliminated, say IZ and minus IZ, minus Z, 1 and minus 1, this is eliminated. So this is I times whatever is remaining, minus 2Z plus 2i equals to W times, here also something will be eliminated, so z will be eliminated and I will be eliminated. So W times whatever will be there, minus 2 plus 2iz. So that is 2 will go from both sides. So this is minus iz plus I square equals to W times minus 1 plus iz. So W equals to I square minus iz minus plus I square divided by iz minus 1. So minus iz I square is minus 1 divided by iz minus 1. So now this is the final mapping. Okay. So what is the finding of a bilinear map using cross ratio? If 3 points are given, you assume the 4th point and you apply cross ratio in both the sides. Then you simplify it, you get the final mapping. So this is the bilinear map, required map, which maps this quantity. So I think you can understand the cross ratio and this thing. Now, one thing, say, cross ratio of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, it was basically Z1 minus Z2, Z3 minus Z4 divided by Z1 minus Z4, Z3 minus Z2. Say, if Z1 is infinity, say out of this Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, any one of the term is infinity, which may be possible, then what will be the thing? The term which containing Z1, that is this one and this one, that will be treated as 1. So now the cross ratio will be Z3 minus Z4, Z3 minus Z2. Understand? So if something is infinity, so here that term will be treated as 1. So here Z1 was infinity, so this term Z1 is present, this term Z1 is present, so this is becoming 1, this is becoming 1. So the remaining will be the cross ratio. So that's all for cross ratio. Now, conformal mapping, which is very important. What is the meaning of conformal mapping? Try to understand this diagram, then only it will be okay. Say there are two curves, C1 and C2. So this will be the angle between these two curves. Say we have given a mapping W equals to FZ, and this is the mapped curve. Say this is C1 star, this is C2 star. So C1 maps to C1 star. So this curve has changed like this, and C2 maps to C2 star. Then also we get some angle theta, get some angle, say phi. Okay. Now, how to measure the angle between two curves? You draw the tangent, and the angle between tangent will be the measurement of that two curve. Here also you can draw. So now, if theta equals to phi, so after changing by a mapping, if the angle is becoming same, then this mapping is called conformal mapping. So what is the meaning of conformal mapping? Conformal mapping means there are two curves, they intersect at a point Z0, suppose. Now say the angle is 60 degree. Now we have given the mapping, the curves are changing, and here we have got a new intersection point, which is the image of this one, then the angle should be also 60. So if the angle preserves in this manner, then it is called conformal mapping. Okay, so that is the thing. Now, in exam, you can't do all these things, or in problem solving, you can't do. So what is the condition for being a conformal mapping? So condition, a mapping FZ will be conformal at a point Z0 if F dash Z0 not equals to 0. So you find the derivative at that point. If the derivative is non-zero, then the mapping will be conformal at that point. Okay. For example, let us Okay, that is something you have need to know. So if f dash z naught not equals to 0, then z naught is called critical point. That means a conformal mapping will be, a mapping will be conformal at all the critical points where the derivative is non-zero, where the derivative is non-zero. So let us take one simple example and try to explain that. Say we can take fz equals to z square and z naught equals to 1 plus I. We have to check whether the mapping is conformal at z naught or not. Okay. So if f of z is z square, so that can be written x plus iy square. This is u plus iv. So if you compare, u should be x square minus y square, v should be 2xy. And the point is 1 plus I, which means 1 comma 1. Now what do you know? F dash z will be ux plus I into vx from analytic function. So what is ux? 2x, that is the partial derivative of u with respect to x. 2x plus I, vx means 2y. Okay? Now at 1, 1 point, it should be 2 plus I into 2, that is 2 times 1 plus I. It is non-zero, so the mapping is conformal at 1 plus I. Okay? So today's class we discuss many things about mapping. The first thing, we have given you some tools. The first thing is that we discuss what is the meaning of cross ratio, and using cross ratio, how you can find a bilinear transformation. So we have given one example thoroughly. Then we have given you the geometrical idea of conformal mapping. You can get the definition in any book. So we have given you the geometrical idea of conformal mapping. Then we have shown that geometry will not work on paper. So on paper, you have to find some formula or some condition. So what is the condition? If the derivative is non-zero at that point, then it is conformal. So then we have shown some example. So thank you for watching this class. If you have any doubt, in this is not a very easy topic, there are many if and buts are there. So if you have any doubt, you please mention me in the comment section, and please visit the channel. You get new videos. Thank you.